Organizations use various sales models, sell different offerings, and track different metrics. That's why forecast types allow you to customize your forecasting process to align with these unique sales processes and goals. You can forecast on amount or quantity from different objects such as opportunities, splits, or product schedules. And you can specify filters to segment your forecast. For example, by new business versus renewals. And you can also set your forecast to roll up by any dimension, such as role hierarchy, which you would see in the opportunity revenue type, territory hierarchy, or with your product families. Now let's take a look at the territory forecast, but first I'm going to show you how it is modeled. This is a territory hierarchy, which defines the roll-up that is visible on the forecasting page. But it can be modeled beyond regions to fit your organizational selling motion, whether it be accounts or team structure. And in this case, territory forecasting is based on geolocation hierarchy, but it can also be modeled to be based on industries or account sizes, enabling matrix hierarchies and overlays. Now let's go back to our forecasting page and take a look at our current month. Here we see the different reps that are assigned to the territories, and we can see how their forecasting categories are doing. As always, we can make adjustments to the numbers and leave a note for leadership. And of course, you can see associated opportunities all while staying within the single view.